Hello guys, how are you? It's long time since we met. Otherwise, welcome back to our lesson. We have been discussing about conjunctions. I want to guess that you haven't forgotten what we have been discussing. Know that we started with different types of conjunction. We said that we have got four types of conjunctions. Then we talked about conjunction number one, number two. Today, good enough, we are going to conjunction type number three. And this conjunction, today we are going to talk about conjunctions that show contrast. What is contrast? Contrast tells us about contradicting. These are statements which are not agreeing to each other, meaning there is a negative and a positive statement. So in short, these conjunctions are used to join two contradicting statements, meaning in these statements we are going to have a positive statement and a negative statement, such that at the end of the day the reader is going to be left hanging. You're going to ask yourself, how did it happen? And that's why we say that this conjunction joins two contradicting statements. The statements must be contradicting, and that's why we will channel down to go through examples of these conjunctions which show contrast or are contradicting. Number one, we have got but, though, although, however, nevertheless, yet, even, and lastly, though. They are going to come down on the screen so that if it is good, you can be making notes. And I guess that you have been making notes out of this. Now, I want to make you understand much better as we go on with this discussion. Now, how to make you understand? We are going to have different examples. We are going to have some sentences with this conjunction that shows contrast, or they are contradicting, so that you can understand better. Now, so let's have a few examples of statements or of sentences with these conjunctions. Number one, let's have: the teacher was sick, but he taught the whole day. You can imagine. The teacher was sick. What do you expect? When somebody is sick, they mean the person is weak. But at the end, we are told that this teacher taught till the end, or taught the whole day. You'll ask yourself, how did this teacher merit? And that's why we say that there are two statements there. Number one, the teacher is sick. And statement number two, he taught the whole day. You'll ask yourself, how did this teacher made it? So, the word but, this conjunction, joins these two statements. The first statement is negative, but the second statement is positive. So, but has been used to join these two sentences. Number two, the farmers had low harvest this year, although the rains were heavy. Like now, this is the season. It is now, it is rainy season. You can imagine the way it is raining. Farmers have been waiting for this rain. But regardless of having a lot of rain, the farmers still recorded low production. You'll ask yourself, what went wrong? And that's why we say that the farmers had low harvest this year, although the rains were heavy. You ask yourself, always ask yourself, what went wrong? Good. Number three example. Even though she knows the place, we won't accept to go. Even though she knows the place, we won't accept to go. Now, you expect that since maybe Jane knows where the place where you're supposed to go, but you still don't accept to go. You will always ask herself, even the reader will ask herself, why did they refuse to go? And yet Jane knows the place, Jane knows the direction. Why did they fail? Did they want to go? Since you are left with a question mark that shows contrast, or these statements are contradicting. Let's have the statement number 4. However tired you feel, you must finish this, you must finish the race. You know, there's nothing hard like running, my friend, or rather being involved in any kind of race. But you're told that even after running for a long time, you're told that however tired you feel, my friend, you have to finish the race. You know, you expect that since you are tired, you have to take a rest, but you're told that you have to finish the race. Let's have example number 5, which is going to close for us the discussion of today. The boy was in class the whole day, yet he did not even do a single assignment. How do I understand you? You have been in class the whole day. Then, when I go through your assignment, you've not done even a single assignment. You see, we expect that since you are in class the whole day, you ought to have finished everything, all the assignments you are given. But here, you've not done even a single assignment. I'll ask myself, what went on or what happened? Very good, guys. So to wrap up our discussion, know that today we were discussing about conjunction that shows contrast, and we have given the few examples of these conjunctions and plus the examples. Please, guys, as we finish, don't forget to log into our website. You'll get assignment for you guys to do, and good enough. Thank you, guys. You have been doing your work. Very good. Congratulations. I give you credit on that. You have been doing your work. You have been bringing your work for marking. And after that, maybe if you haven't received your papers, you've not come for them. You should come for them and see where you went wrong. Till next time, guys. I can't forget to tell you that, guys, you keep safe. If you have got nothing to do outside, you don't need to go outside. And if you have got unnecessary reason for taking you to for you to go outside, my brother or sister, stay indoor and keep yourself safe. Guys, till next time, good day.